Alrighty, boys, the story unfolds. The lawsuit of Activision gets stranger and stranger. Now, stuff might actually happen. We'll get into that in a little bit. Damascus update. I literally need 70 kills with the Riot Shield, and that's platinum. I finished off the XM4 pistol last night. I just needed headshots, and like my final feed to get my headshots done was pretty nice. And then I also finished off the Dragunov on shipment, and that means I got platinum snipers now. Now I just need shotguns and pistols and 70 kills with the shield, and I'm Damascus. And for those that were commenting yesterday on the video when we were talking about alcohol and just random stuff like that, I appreciate those that came out and shared their stories. I know the internet's not like the craziest place you want to share some of that stuff, but the comment section was actually pretty positive yesterday, regardless of how, I guess, important the topic was to social standards of humans and stuff like that. But yeah, it was nice to see some nice conversations in there, and it brought some humanity to the comment section. And for the first time in a long time, I would say 90% of the comment section was wholesome. And I'm not going to sugarcoat it saying the comment section's a safe place, because we all know it's not. But yeah, keep that up, because it was nice to interact with you guys, and we had some good conversations yesterday. Anyway, let's talk about the Activision lawsuit. There's no new developments or anything crazy. However, instead of the state government of California handling the lawsuit has now been sent to the federal court of the United States. So the US government is now in control of the outcome of the lawsuit. And I'm very uneducated when it comes to US politics and the US legal system. But from what I've heard, the California legal system, if you're rich, you can pretty much get away with a lot. So the fact that the United States government is taking over the lawsuit rather than just the state of California. No offense to California and those handling the case, but honestly, it seems like if the United States government takes hold of this case, actually some stuff might come out of it, just because Blizzard and Activision just can't pay off the California government like a lot of celebrities do in the first place and go, hey, look, we're out of this scot-free. And I think we all know how messed up this Activision lawsuit is, and it's pretty crazy to think that this happened, or at least started happening in 2018, and we're only hearing about this now. But Activision, we know, has never been a good company in the eyes of the public. I remember when this lawsuit came out, there was tons of people comparing Activision to EA. And honestly, with the lawsuit going on, I would say EA is a more reputable company than Activision from my perspective, which says a lot. Not that either company is good. I still think like both companies are like some of the worst companies, if not the two worst companies in the industry right now in the public eye, and just kind of overall with how bad their business practices have been and just how lazy they get. And yeah, that's, we all know that. But yeah, it's good to see that the government of the United States is going to be taking over this case. Not that that means anything. Not that means anything's going to change Call of Duty wise or Activision wise, because there's corruption in all levels of the government, regardless of where you are. The government has dirty money in it somehow. Like, for example, in Canada, where I live and where I reside, the province of Quebec has a Quebec mob. Like most places have mob, like New York has an Italian mob and there's all that type of stuff. But there's a Quebec mob that actually has a lot of influence in the government, because they're sticking their nose in the government for influence so they can get away with stuff. That's just kind of how it works worldwide. There's the Russian mob. Like, there's mobs everywhere. We know that. So there's obvious corruption on all levels of it. But yeah, this doesn't mean that it's going to change anything, but it gives me a little bit more hope. Honestly, I don't expect anything to change from where we are now with this lawsuit, especially because from when the lawsuit first broke, Activision stock dropped, and then there was a lot of hate sent Activision's way because of obvious reasons. But everyone's just kind of swept it under the rug now and kind of forgot about it. And I'm guilty of that too. When I think of the Activision lawsuit and everyone boycotting against Activision and going for change and stuff like that, I really haven't thought about it since it originally started months ago. And I guess people have done their walkouts and all that stuff, and there is that movement for safe workspaces at Activision. And since then, I haven't heard anything about it. Hopefully, what I'm hoping, honestly, and what should have happened is, because of everything that has gone on, everything at Activision should be back in a more than professional workspace, but we never know, right? And it sucks to see this so close to home. And the reason I say so close to home is because Call of Duty is my favorite game franchise. It has been ever since I got my first PS3, and even before that, when I was playing games at friends' houses after hockey games or anything like that, Call of Duty was like the first gaming franchise that I really fell in love with gaming with. When I was young, I was playing like the Nintendo 64, like Banjo-Kazooie and Pokemon Puzzle League and kind of like those types of games and Pokemon Stadium. And then the GameCube came out and I was playing games like Sonic XD and like all those types of old console games. And I was always like happy to play those games, and it was like escape from reality, but I never really wanted to play them for very long, so I would always go play outside or just do something other than that. But when I got my hands on Call of Duty at my friend's house during World at War, man, did I fall in love with that game. And then when I got my own console, I was grinding Call of Duty, and it's been my favorite ever since. So that's what I mean by it hits so close to home. Activision being the publisher company just adds this bad taste in my mouth when I think about actually how Call of Duty is developed. And that bad taste in my mouth has been there ever since Advanced Warfare had supply drops and Activision went downhill business-wise years ago. But this just adds even more bad taste into my mouth. And it's like, it's bittersweet because Call of Duty to this day is still my favorite franchise of video game. I'm such a COD fanboy, I'll admit it, that I honestly haven't disliked a single game. Like, there's been games that I've liked more than others, and games like Ghost and Advanced Warfare that I dislike more than most, but I still played those games and had fun when they were a thing. I got to Prestige 10 in both games, got Royalty Camo in Advanced Warfare. During Infinite Warfare, I did zombies all the time. I played multiplayer a little bit, but the reason I didn't play the multiplayer was because it was pretty much a Black Ops 3 clone, and then I just migrated to Modern Warfare Remastered because COD 4 is the shit. But it's just, it sucks, man, because Call of Duty during like the early 2010s was at such an incredible place in just the gaming atmosphere. Without that, Call of Duty wouldn't be as mainstream as it was today. And Call of Duty, quote unquote, was niche back then, niche being millions of players rather than tens and of hundreds of millions of players. And all these celebrities started streaming and that kind of online culture. I think the reason that COD's golden era was the golden era was also because of like the time and popularity of video games. It was like the Goldilocks zone for Call of Duty in general, maybe other games too, but Call of Duty wasn't seen as being very nerdy anymore, but it wasn't also mainstream in the sense where everyone, regardless of who you were, knew or played it, right? It was in that nice Goldilocks zone, and just ever since then, Activision's just tanked it downhill. So hopefully this lawsuit will make Activision think properly, which honestly might not happen, because you have to think at the end of the day, it's not just the players and the developers. Like, honestly, okay, I'm gonna restate this. The players and the developers are the people that get affected the most by the higher ups' mistakes. Like, so if you guys don't know, the publishers is Activision and the developers are Treyarch, Sledgehammer, Infinity Ward, Raven, but like all those sub developers of the game, they just make the game. They just work on art because it's their passion, and they try to make the game as best as they can. And then Activision's the one that always messes everything up, implements skill-based matchmaking, implements all these microtransactions, puts a bad light on Call of Duty because their workplace is a horrible place to work when it shouldn't be. And that's just kind of how it goes. And so the players and the developers that care about the game and enjoy the game, it's just a bad reputation for the franchise and everything because the higher ups screw up, right? Like, that's just how it works, not only here but everywhere. Like, look at governments, for example, since the US government is taking over. It's just not the US government in general, but if any government messes up, it makes the whole country look bad. Look at how bad the United States look with Donald Trump in office, and even now with Joe Biden in office. Look at how dumb the Canadian government seems every time Justin Trudeau makes a mistake. And trust me, it's a lot. I am a Canadian conservative, which is like still very liberal for Americans, but even in Canada, like, my own parties that I enjoy make mistakes. Look at the province of Alberta. If you guys want to know how bad the conservatives have been in Canada recently, Google Alberta's COVID response. Like, that's literally all you need to know. So it just trickles down and it makes everything kind of like tarnished at the end of the day. So hopefully Activision like kind of like lays low for a couple years. Honestly, that I think that's like the best choice, and then maybe the U.S. government can enact some change in the company, but because of corruption and stuff like that, we will never know. Anyway, let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below on what you guys have to add to the discussion. Yeah, leave a like if you guys did enjoy, dislike if you didn't. There's no hard feelings. Subscribe for more videos in the future. I'm about to head out. Use code WILD for 10% off gamersubs.gg. Always linked in the description below. Helps save you guys some money and help support the channel. Anyway, I'm about to head out. If there is one, I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.